Hello, welcome to my channel. So in this video we are going to discuss about how the roller conveyor is being designed. So aspect of roller conveyor design. In our previous video you have already known about, we have already discussed about the roller conveyor supports, what is the different type of roller conveyor. So actually the roller conveyor supports of unit type of loads on a series of rollers mounted on bearing. And in case of roller conveyor, there are some frames which supports the roller conveyor. Okay, now this case of roller conveyor, you know that the, there are some certain gap between two rollers, and these rollers, they can be powered or non-powered type of conveyors. Okay, in case of unpowered or gravity roller conveyor, why this is called gravity roller conveyor? Because you know that gravity principle is used for unpowered roller conveyor, where the roller conveyor, unpowered roller conveyor is slightly inclined at a certain of 1.5% to 3% inclination happens due to using the gravity principle for movement of the load automatically. Okay, now in case of gravity roller conveyor, it consists of cylindrical rollers. Then the roller diameter actually depends on the load amount of load which it is being carried. Okay, then there is the fabricated frame. In fabricated frame, actually the rollers are being placed. Then there are supporting strands, which is also known as trestles, and there is a stops at the end of conveyor, and the use of this stop is actually protecting the load which is being carried through the conveyor, and at the end of the conveyor it is not being fall down in the shop floor, and this stop actually helps them to stop there at the end of the conveyor movement. It actually ends the movement of the material on the roller conveyor. In case of powered roller conveyor, it actually consists of driven rollers. Now this driven roller is quite different from the normal cylindrical roller which is being used in the unpowered roller conveyor. Now in case of these driven rollers, there are some bearing, journal bearing available at the end of two sides of the shaft, and this bearing housing, it actually placed inside the fabricated frame, and there are some drive arrangement which can be group or individual drive arrangement available for moving these type of driven rollers in case of powered roller conveyor. Now we will see how the design is being made for the roller conveyor in case of both powered and unpowered conveyor. So we are going to solve how the roller conveyor is being designed. So if we talk about how the aspects of roller conveyor, so aspects of roller conveyor design. Okay, so you have already know that we have already discussed about there are two type of roller conveyors available. One is the unpowered roller conveyor and another is the powered roller conveyor. So our design calculation have to be considered for the unpowered roller conveyor as well as the powered roller conveyor. Now the major design calculation for unpowered roller conveyor, that actually involves to find out what is the force required to overcome the total resistance during the motion of the loads and the angle of inclination required for a unpowered roller conveyor, which is generally known as gravity conveyor. Okay, so basically we have to find out what is the total resistance total resistance against the motion. So basically this total resistance that is actually included, number one is the resistance to rolling resistance. Now this rolling resistance for the load on the rollers due to friction. Okay, this rolling resistance actually happens due to the friction of the roller. Then this is basically the basic rolling resistance. Then number two, since there is friction available, what I have already said for this rolling resistance, so that's why we have to again overcome this frictional resistance. So
we have to consider the frictional resistance. Okay. So frictional resistance in the basically frictional resistance happen in case of roller bearing. Okay, so in case of roller bearing, this type of frictional resistance happen. Now number three, that is the resistance due to the sliding of the load. So resistance for sliding of load. Now this sliding of load on the rollers, it happens due to the force required for imparting the kinetic energy to the rollers. Okay, so whenever you are going to find out this sliding load resistance, you have to calculate the imparting kinetic energy load, or you have to find out the imparting kinetic energy force, okay, which is applied on the roller. So first we need to find out rolling resistance. Okay, so rolling resistance. So in case of rolling resistance, if the total load is marked by the term G, then rolling resistance, you already know, in case of belt conveyor or chain conveyor, we are finding this resistance by the force F1, suppose G into K by R. This is small k, where this small k, that small k is the rolling friction factor. Okay, and in case of R, this R is the radius of roller. Basically this radius, it is in form of centimeter. Okay, so this is your first formula, the rolling resistance. So you just mark this formula. This formula will help you to solve any kind of numerical problems. Okay, then number two, what we need to find out. So first one, the rolling resistance, we have found out. Then the second thing, we have to find out the frictional resistance. So number two, that is the frictional resistance. Now this frictional resistance actually occurs on the roller journals, and it is also expressed by another F term, that means the force term, that is so we have considered F1 over here for rolling resistance. Now for frictional resistance, we are considering F2. F2 equal to G, you know G, then W n dash mu small r by capital R. Now capital R, you already know, which is radius of the roller, what I have already discussed. G, you know the load, what I have already discussed earlier. Now what is n dash? N dash is the number of rollers supporting load, and W is the load of the roller. Okay, so weight of not load of the roller, actually it is weight of rotating part. So basically you can say it is the weight of the total roller, that is W. Mu, you know the coefficient of friction. Now this mu, coefficient of friction, is actually happening in the journal or journal bearing, which is adjacent to the inside of the roller conveyor. Okay, and small r, so again I am writing this, mu is the frictional coefficient for the journal bearing. Okay, and R is the journal radius. So you can easily find out what are the basic terminologies over here by which we can easily find out the frictional resistance. So this is your another formula. First one is the rolling resistance, then you find out the frictional resistance, and third we need to find out resistance due to sliding on the load. So when we are discussing about the resistance due to the sliding sliding load, so when a moving load comes over a static roller, it actually slides over the roller. Okay, you have already seen this in any kind of suppose in the airport or railway station, when you are putting the luggage over the roller conveyor, and when the load comes over the roller conveyor, it actually start moving. Okay, so same thing happens over here. So when the load comes over a static roller, it slides over the roller and start accelerating the roller till the roller attains the surface equal speed to the speed of the load. Okay, when this load leaves the roller, it start decelerating, and eventually it stops until it is again accelerated by the next load. So this is the procedure how the roller conveyor actually works, unpowered roller conveyor obviously. So it actually, the movement of the rollers actually depends on the load, where you have to push or pull the load. So because it is, since it is unpowered, so you have to give her extra effort for movement of the rollers. Okay, now if you see this figure, the velocity diagram of the roller, how the roller moves, actually O is this point when a moving load touches a static roller. So this is your starting point. Till the time t, till the time t dash, the load rolls and slides over the roller. So this is the point where the load actually started rolling and it slides over the roller. The surface or the rotational velocity of the roller is under acceleration now, and this line, that means the rotational velocity line, that is expressed by this one, OA line. Okay, and from A to B, this A to B, the load rolls over the roller, and B, it leaves the roller. So since you can see, this is your velocity, this is your time. Okay, and by the means of velocity and time graph, it's starting from zero, it accelerates due to this period OA, and the time taken is t dash, and from B to C is actually deacceleration is happening over here, it is slowing down, and at C it becomes zero. Again from point B, the next load comes and it again repeats the same procedure what I have seen, what you can see over this line. Okay, so this is the total acceleration line, how the roller conveyor moves. Okay, unpowered roller conveyor. Now starting from another load, the time taken, if we consider that as t1, this t1, it is actually, suppose it is conveying z pieces of load per hour, then this cycle period is actually given by t1 equal to 3600 by z seconds. So we can write t1 equal to 3600 by z seconds. This is actually the cycle period of roller. Okay, now suppose you are considering the weight of each load, that is equal to g dash. Okay, if I consider this, and mu zero is the kinetic coefficient of the friction. So kinetic coefficient of friction. Then the frictional sliding force between the load and the roller during that time t dash, this t dash time. So frictional sliding force, that is equal to g dash mu 0. Okay, and work done, then since it is g dash mu 0, so work done, that will be g dash mu 0 phi t dash, v means the velocity over here. So this will be the work done during this time. Okay, now this area, this thing, this is given by the area of OEAF. OEAF, this area is actually representing the work done over here, starting work done when the load is accelerating over the roller. Now the distance traveled by any point on the periphery of the roller during this time, that will be actually area OAF. OAF, this distance, the t dash time during this t dash time, the distance traveled that is v t dash by 2. Okay. Which is actually the sliding path. Okay, now if we consider the weight of the rotating part of the roller, what I have already discussed in the frictional resistance, this weight of the roller, weight of the rotating part of the roller, that is W, then kinetic energy for roller, that will be half W by G V square Q. Now this Q is a factor, this Q is a constant factor, the value between 0.8 to 0.9. Why this factor is taken 0.8 to 0.9? Because you know that not all the mass of the roller moving part is on the periphery. Okay, since it is a circular, all the mass is not on the periphery. That's why it is not, thereby it is not moving with the velocity v of the total part. Total part is not moving with the velocity v. Therefore, we are considering this factor. Now, the work done due to the sliding and acceleration is given by, actually the work done due to sliding, that will be 2 into this one, kinetic energy, 2 into kinetic energy of roller, that will be equal to WV square Q by G. Okay. And if the number of rollers we consider in total length L, for N rollers with L length, then total work done, that will be equal to N into W V square Q by G. Okay, which is moving throughout the conveyor. Then average resistance, that will be equal to F3 dash N W V Q Q by GL. Okay. Sorry, V square. Now, if we consider Z0 number of loads moving simultaneously on the conveyor, then the average total resistance for Z0 number of loads due to sliding and acceleration will be, it will be F3 Z0 N W V square Q by G L. Okay, so this is the formula for Z0. Z0 is the number of load over here. Therefore, total resistance to motion of the load, which is the force required to move the loads on a horizontal unpowered conveyor, total force required, that is F equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3. Okay, so the term that will become F equal to G K by R plus G plus WN dash mu R by R plus Z0 N W V square Q by GL. Okay, so this is the total force for a roller conveyor. This is the total force for a horizontal unpowered roller conveyor. Now we can define the equivalent resistance to the motion factor F by the equation of F equal to G into small f. Okay, sorry, F capital F force, that is equal to GF. Okay, so this F is actually motion factor. So motion factor F can be also treated by F by G, and if we divide it by G, then it will be K by R, it will be by G. Okay, and G will be over here. So there will be another formula, and now you can say this will be equal to 2K by T. Since we are considering R over here, we are now taking D, 2, D by 2, that is R. D is the diameter of the roller, and which is 2R, capital R. Then again, 1 plus WN dash by G mu D by D. Now this small d, again this is R. We are taking D by 2, and again small d by 2. 2 will cancel out, and that will be small d by capital D. Okay, then Z0 N W V square Q by G L capital G. However, for calculating the minimum inclination angle beta, which is actually the inclination angle for gravity conveyor, so inclination angle for gravity conveyor or roller conveyor, unpowered roller conveyor, that is beta. So beta equal beta we can calculate by F equal to tan beta. So that is equal to G dash, F by G dash. Okay, now G dash is the weight of each load. So this G dash can be given by weight of each load, G by Z0. And for this reason, we can also find out the number of rollers supporting each load. This, for this formula, tan beta, that will be equal to 2K by D. We are considering each load for each roller, okay, over here, 1 plus W. Now we are considering N double dash, which is the number of rollers supporting each load. Okay. Suppose a load which is moving through a roller conveyor is moving on two or three rollers at a time. That's why we are considering this N double dash. And for this formula, we are considering two or three rollers at which the load is occupied. Okay, so the load is actually occupying two or three rollers when it is moving for every instance, and we are considering that only over here. So it will be mu small d by d plus q, n w v squared q by g l g dash. Okay, so this is the formula by which we can easily find out the beta, tan beta, or the inclination angle for the conveyor. Now, for certain case, if we consider n double dash by g dash, so that will be n dash by z0, again g by z0. Now, n double dash is the n double dash, that is equal to actually n dash by z0. Okay, number of rollers supporting by each load. Z0 is the number of load. Now, if this is cancelled out, it will be n dash by g. So actually, this is nothing but n double dash by g dash is nothing but n dash by g. Okay, both are almost same. So these are the formula by which you can easily find out what are the inclination angle for the gravity conveyor as well as the total force. We can find out the total force and the inclination angle for gravity conveyor or unpowered conveyor. Now the next thing what we need to find out, that is for the powered conveyor, powered roller conveyor. Now in case of powered roller conveyor, basically it is known as the transport conveyor. Now for transport or powered conveyor. Okay. Now for this type of conveyor, if the conveying rate is conveying rate that is q tons per hour, then we have to calculate the vertical and horizontal component of the length for this type of transport or power conveyor, since it is automated. So if we consider V and LH are the two components through length L, okay, in meter, considering number of rollers, that is equal to N, and each roller's weight, that is equal to W, this is in kg, and conveying speed, that is equal to V meter per second. Okay, so considering all of these things, we have to find out what is the motor power. That motor power P, which will be in form of kilowatt, that will be sum of total power requirements for raising the load through the vertical distance, rolling the load on the rollers, and rotating the rollers against the journal resistance. So combining all of these three, we can easily find out what is the motor power. So it is given by the formula of QV by 367 plus QLH. LH, you know that the horizontal component of the length, 367, it is a basic constant term, 2K by D plus mu small d by d. K, you already know that what is K, plus n w v by 102 mu d by capital D into 1 by nu, where nu is the efficiency of drive system. Now for a horizontal conveyor, for a horizontal conveyor, obviously it's a powered conveyor, when V equal to 0 and LH equal to L, the equation will be P equal to QL by 367 D 2K plus mu D plus N W mu D V by 102 D 1 by nu, that will be in form of kilowatt. So this is the formula of the power required to move the total load. Okay, now if we consider the weight G dash of each load in kg and number of piece, total number of piece of load, that is Z, which is transported per hour, then so G dash is the load in kg and Z is number of piece transported per hour, then P will be equal to G dash Z L 367 into 1000 into D 2K plus mu D plus N W V mu D by 102 D 1 by nu kilowatt. Okay, so this is the formula by which you can easily find out the total motor power. And if the unit load are fed uniformly, then the interval between two load, that will be given by T equal to 3600 by Z. Okay, and time through each load moves in the conveyor is given by time for each load movement, that is given by T equal to L by small v seconds. Hence the number of load moving simultaneously on the conveyor, that will be Z0, that is equal to T by small t, that is equals to ZL by 3600 V species. Okay, so by this way, if we consider all of these terms over here, then the required motor power, that will be P equal to Z0 G dash 2K mu D plus N W mu D V by 102 D nu, that will be in form of kilowatt. Okay, so this is the way how we are solving the motor power for the powered roller conveyor.
So if I draw the quick summary from this lecture video, so you can easily find out how the total resistance is available for the unpowered horizontal roller conveyor, that is combining all the resistances which is finding out through the calculation of the forces, that is F1, F2 and F3, And again, the minimum inclination angle beta for a gravity convert, that is unpowered roller convert, it is also being calculated by using the formula. And for horizontal powered convert, you know that we need to find out what is the motor power required, which is given by this formula, where nu is the efficiency, and we can also find out what is the skidding torque for the reversing convert from this formula. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you find any difficulty, you can easily comment under the video section. Now you can also follow my channel through this link, and please subscribe my channel, like the video if you like the total roller conveyor related videos. For more video, please watch my channel. Thank you.